Bimini Bon Boulash.
Bimini!
She's the loud,
all right, babe,
proud British drag queen who rose to fame on season 2 of RuPaul's Drag Race. In the UK, hun, fans grew to love Bimini's real talk on the show as they served up some fierce anatomy lessons.
The nipples are the eyes of the face.
All while looking utterly fabulous.
My nails are great, my teeth are great. If that doesn't save me from the apocalypse, what will?
Since then, Bimini's penned a new book that tackles the serious side of drag and gender fluidity and released a song to match.
And Bimini joins us now all the way from London.
Hello, how's it going? Thank you for having me.
We're going very well. Your new book is called Release the Beast. I don't know if I should ask this. What kind of beast are you referring to exactly?
It's the beast within. It's the lyrics that I'd written for while I was on RuPaul's Drag Race UK, and it kind of took off a life of its own. People were kind of... I'd walk down the road and people would shout, "Release the beast" at me. So I thought it was quite a fitting title.
Well, the book actually details how drag saved your life. What are you hoping readers take away from it?
I'm hoping people can kind of read another perspective. Maybe someone isn't so attuned to kind of discussions around different identities or the way drag as an art form. So I think I talk about that a lot in the book, how I use it to kind of express myself, be creative, and it really kind of helped find my light again, because I feel like I kind of lost that, got caught up in the system and all of that stuff. So I feel like drag really did help me, and I hope people can maybe understand or read a perspective that's kind of radically different to theirs. And I think that's a beautiful thing, to be able to be open to other people's point of view.
Bimini Bon Boulash is an awesome drag name, but you also go by London's plant-based princess. Tell me, what vegan superfood gets you to do this?
Oh,
man.
Ouch.
Well, I'm not eating anywhere near enough kale, obviously. How do you do that?
I have tender lentils. That's what does it for me.
That's incredible. Like, have you always been that athletic?
Yeah, do you know what? I grew up, I wasn't good at necessarily the typically masculine sports that I was kind of taught to do in school. I was dancing around to Britney Spears. So I kind of got into that when I was a bit younger, and I just loved playing around. I did a lot of pole dancing as well. It's a very great fitness. And I know it's big in Australia, pole.
Absolutely. I mean, I don't know why you've come to me all of a sudden like I'm the pole queen. I was going to say is that lentils make me windy, so doing that move would be disastrous, I feel.
Well, good job it was filmed on TV, wasn't it?
Let's talk Drag Race UK. You came runner-up, and a lot of fans said that you were robbed of the title. Would you agree?
I think anyone that was in the final could have deserved to win. It was all like it was anyone's game at that point. And I think Lawrence was a very worthy winner. I think it's given me such an amazing platform to talk on things that I want to do and talk about and do the things I do. So I'm very grateful for that.
It's very diplomatic.
Yes,
very diplomatic.
It is a lovely answer.
I don't think you believe a word of that. Anyway, Bimini's book is called Release the Beast. It is out tomorrow.
Release the Beast!
Thanks so much for the chat.
Thank you.
What a great video, and we've got plenty more, so why not click the subscribe button here? Or is it here? Or is it... Sorry, I can't see the button. I'm not wearing my glasses. But you can see it, so you click on it to make sure you don't miss any more content.